in this video I will discuss some questions from exercise 8.1. Earlier we have done question number 1, question number 2, question number 4, 5, 6, 7. Now we will begin with the construction of a parallelogram. Here in question number 8 and 9, two different cases are discussed. So before we start with the construction of the parallelogram, we will return back towards the previous lesson, that is chapter 7, in which we will discuss some of the definitions of different polygons. But before that, you should know some of the properties of parallelogram. So before we read out from the book, I have summarized some of the points for you here. So looking at the definition of the parallelogram, and we will begin with the properties. Parallelogram is a special type of quadrilateral whose pair of opposite sides are parallel. For example, quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram, as you can see here, A, B, C and D. Now, if you look at the parallel side, you should know what parallel lines are. So parallel lines are those lines that never meet each other or they never intersect each other, and they are at the same distance apart. Now here if we see, first point says pair of opposite sides are parallel. So side AB is parallel to side CD and side AD is parallel to side BC. Here I have written it in symbolic form also. So point number 2 says pair of opposite angles are congruent, and the word congruent means equal. So opposite angles like angle A is congruent to angle C and angle B is congruent to angle D. Now sum of opposite or sum of consecutive angles are supplementary. Here if you see, consecutive angle means angle that are along are on the same side, like angle A and angle D. When we take the sum of these two, we will get supplementary angle. In the same way, when we take sum of angle B and C, we will get supplementary angles. One angle like angle A is obtuse angle, the other one, angle D, will be acute angle. Similarly, angle C will be an obtuse angle and angle B will be an acute angle. So when we take the sum of angle A and D, we will get supplementary angle. Similarly, sum of angle B and C, we will again get supplementary angle. Next point, the diagonal bisect each other. So the diagonals, if you see here, AC and the diagonal BD. Children, remember here, diagonal is that line segment that join the opposite vertices of any shape. Like A and C, these are opposite vertices. So diagonal AC and diagonal BD, they join or they intersect each other at a point O. So they are bisecting each other at point O. Next, last point, the sum of all the interior angles is 360 degree. This is very obvious because we have done this in our previous lessons also, that the sum of interior angles of all the quadrilateral is equal to 360 degree. Now, after reading all these properties from your book also, children, you have to write these properties in your copies and study them from page 129 from the book. So after watching this video, learn the properties by your heart, and then we will start with the construction of a parallelogram. Thank you.